Dear friends, welcome to India-China Cultural Forum. Today our presentation is on Hinduism in China, the intertwined cultural roots of India-China. Age-old instances of cultural links between India and China, where scholars and travelers visited each other's nations for the sole purpose of learning and exchange of educational values. Today, many of us are unaware that Chinese and Indian culture are intertwined with Hindu roots, and this can be traced back to the earliest possible nexus in Asian history. My name is Dr. Das Bikashkali. I am a researcher in the field of India-China cultural relations, founder of XuFancheng Culture Study Center and Pondicherry India-China Friendship Association. For any queries and reaching out to me, you can mail me at thebikashkali@gmail.com. Introduction. Cross-cultural exchanges between the two civilizations have been traced back at least to the Qin and Han dynasties. The great epics of Indian Itihasa, the Ramayana and the Mahabharata, contains numerous references to China. Chinese monks Xuanzang and Fashian journeyed to India for Buddhist scriptures and knowledge, while renowned Indian monks Kumar Jiva and Bodhidharma spread their teachings in China. The Chinese concept of Hinduism. To understand the concept of Hinduism in China, we should know the Chinese word called Poloman and its meaning. This word is derived from the Vedic literatures of Indian Hinduism, which means the practice of Brahminism. Poloman. In China, the Brahmin community are called Poloman. They are among the most educated scholars and practitioners of Sanatana Dharma. These peoples are considered to be highly respected peoples in China. Even today, the Brahmin community persons from India, Indonesia and other countries are given a special status by the Chinese peoples. In China, the mostly Han ethnicity practices the Hinduism. Evidences. Hinduism has a significant indirect role in influencing Chinese culture through other cultural beliefs and practices and traditions. The concepts of Hinduism diffused with the concept of Buddhism, Taoism and Confucianism and spread to China from around 1st and 2nd centuries CE onwards. Ramayana in China. During the 1930s, the Chinese archaeologist Hu Wenliang discovered relics carved with the images of Indian gods and Hindu mythology, a forgotten link that inspired many scholars and students in the field of India-China cultural relations. Ghosts and gods of heaven. Arshasa Jutian. Statues of the 24 Devas are enshrined in many Chinese Buddhist temples and monasteries, usually in the Mahavira Hall. Buddhism and Brahminism. Most of the ghosts and gods in Buddhism originated from Indian Brahminism and Indian folk gods. Buddhism opposes Brahminism. Early Buddhism opposed Brahminism's caste supremacy, sacrifice supremacy, and god supremacy. But Buddhism does not deny the existence of gods. It regards gods as an integral part of sentient beings. Some Vedic gods and Brahman gods are also absorbed by Buddhism and became the protector gods of Buddhism. The Golden Light Sutra is one of the most important sutras in China, which teaches that the four heavenly kings protect the ruler who governs his country in the proper manner. The sutra also expounds the vows of the goddesses Saraswati and Lakshmi to protect any saints who uphold and teach the sutra. Gongfu Jaitian. Veneration of the 24 deities has continued into modern Chinese traditions. A puja, a ceremonial worship, called the Gongfu Jaitian, meaning offering to the celestial guardians, where the 24 deities are venerated. It is a cultural custom performed in Chinese Buddhist temples on the ninth day of the first month of Chinese calendar. commemorating the traditional feast day of the Jade Emperor of Taoism. This ceremony started during the Sui dynasty by Ji of the Thien Thai tradition. According to the rites prescribed in the Golden Light Sutra and has been carried down through tradition to the present day. In some temples, the three syncretized Taoist deities as well as the Kinara king are excluded from the list, and the remaining devas are venerated as the 20 protective deities. Thienlong Babu, 8 legions of devas and nagas. Ashtasena, or the 8 legions of devas and nagas, is a group of deities whose function is to protect the dharma. These beings are commonly addressed by the Mahayana sutras. Asuras are also listed here as protectors of dharma, in the same sense as demigods, which is referred as Asuratvam in Holy Rig Veda, where devatas are called Asuras, protectors of dharma. Shangxian, the holy mountain men known as the Shangxian or Indian rishis, are described by Lietzu. Lietzu or Lietzu is a Taoist text attributed to Lie Youho, 5th century BC. Chuangzu of certain Taoists who practices movements are very similar to the asanas of Hindu yoga. Some knowledge of the yoga technique which the Indian rishi practiced possibly were adopted in China's Taoism. The six schools or six doctrines, some examples of influence by Hinduism and ancient Chinese philosophy, included the belief of six schools or six doctrines as well as use of yoga. Stupas, later which became pagoda in East Asia. The first great systematic Chinese history identified six schools, Liu Xia or Liu Xiao. In later period, the six school transformed to nine. Xuanzhou, Hindu communities, particularly through Tamil merchant guilds of Ayavol and Manigramam from South India, once thrived in medieval South China. Evidence of Shiva motifs and temples, such as in the Kaiyuan Temple, continues to be discovered in Xuanzhou, Fujian province of Southeast China. The evidences consist of a Tamil-Chinese bilingual inscription dated April 1281 AD, as well as over 300 artifacts, idols, and Chola-style temple structures discovered in Fujian province since 1933. Archaeological studies suggest at least Vaishnavism and Shaivism schools of Hinduism arrived in China in its history. The Kaiyuan Temple. Architecture of Kaiyuan Temple has a historical influence of Hinduism and Buddhism. Researchers claim that during the late 13th century, there was a Tamil-speaking community in Xuanzhou who built one of the largest Hindu temples in China devoted to Lord Shiva. Sanskrit inscriptions from Yunnan. According to studies by French scholars, the Sanskrit inscriptions is supposed to have been written during the Tang and Sung dynasties, mostly on bricks and tombstones. It can be found mostly in Dali and Lijiang. The Linga and Yoni were discovered in Jian Chuan caves, and Hindu idols and temple parts found during the excavation of Dali Temple in Yunnan. Putoshan Guaning Dharma Rim, Zhoushan Islands. Statue of Shiva in the Buddhist temple in Putoshan Guaning Dharma Rim in Zhejiang, China. Loknor and Kijil Caves in Xinjiang province, where carvings of deity Ganesha, murals seen from Ramayana epic with Hanumana, and frescoes of other Hindu deities can be found. Shaanxi, Yungguang Grottoes, 4th to 6th century AD. This route is also credited with the spread of some Hindu ideas and arts in north central China by 5th century AD into provinces as far as Shaanxi. As evidences by caves 7 through 9 of Yungguang Grottoes in Datong dedicated to various Hindu deities such as Vishnu and Shiva. Sichuan Province, a yogic statue discovered recently in San Xin Dui of Sichuan Province, which dated back 3,700 years ago. Beijing, Sanskrit inscriptions in the Great Wall of China. Role of Indian and Chinese scholars. The scholars played a major role in developing the exchange of knowledge between India and China. There are around 150 scholars during the 12th century AD who focused on translating various Hindu scripts into Chinese, as mentioned by Professor Huangqing Chuan. During the Cultural Revolution in China, the practice of religion was discouraged. During this time, many religious buildings and services were closed and repurposed to serve as more materialistic services. From 1977 onwards, the Chinese government eased their restrictions on religion as the Constitution of the People's Republic of China was signed, and many of the Chinese were allowed to practice their religious and personal beliefs once again. The modern-day China is officially a secular state. There are five official state-recognized religions in China: Buddhism, Taoism, Catholic Christianity, Protestant Christianity, and Islam. Although Hinduism is not included, but the practice of Hinduism is allowed in China along with other religions. Thank you everyone for watching. Please like, subscribe and share, and tell us about your comments.